Hey everyone, it's Johnny from Nurse Hub, and welcome to your lesson on determining meaning using word parts. I hope you enjoy. Now let's begin with the focus of our lesson. And the focus is words. Now, words are really common to us. We see them when we read, we hear them when we listen, we say them when we speak. But what we may not know is words have different parts. And understanding how these parts work can help us to define words that we may not know offhand. Now, there are three different types of word parts, and they all have different jobs. There are the affixes, which are prefixes and suffixes, and then we also have root words, which we'll go over individually in the next slide. Again, understanding these parts and how they work can help us to define words we may not know offhand, both in our work, in our lives, and during the test. So let's get started with root words. Now, root words are the basis of our entire word study. They are a basic word with no prefix or suffix added to it, so they just kind of stand on their own. Now, some root words are able to stand on their own as individual words, but some need a little help. For instance, the root that means water is the word hige. By adding the suffix ate to our root word hige, we get the word hydrate, meaning to absorb water. Like when you take a big gulp out of a glass of water, you're now hydrated. By adding the prefix D to our root suffix combo, we get the word dehydrate, meaning unable to or needing to absorb water. So from these additions to our root word, it changes the meaning of our root word, which simply just means water. Next, let's see how affixes, both suffixes and prefixes, work. Let's start with prefixes, which go before root words. A prefix is a word added before the root word. For instance, the prefix pre, as in prefix, literally means before. By placing this prefix before a root word like game, we get a brand new word, like pregame, meaning before the game. Other common prefixes include inter, sub, un, inter, and even more. These and many other prefixes help us to create meaning by adding them to root words. Next, we have suffixes, which go after our root words. For instance, an example of a suffix is er or or, meaning someone who. By placing the suffix after a root word like train, we get a brand new word, trainer, meaning someone who trains others. Other common suffixes include AC, like accuracy, ants or ents, like interference, ism, shun, and more. These also help to create meaning by interfacing with prefixes and our root words. So as a quick review of our simple word parts, we have root words, which are our basic words. They are the building block of our words. We have prefixes, which is an affix or an addition that's added to the beginning of the root word to change the meaning. And then we have suffixes, which do the same exact thing as prefixes. They're just added to the end of the word. Now, we're going to look at how each of these word parts help to change the meaning of words and how those are used in exact TEAS questions in our next lessons. Thank you so much, and I'll see you again soon.
You did it! Another lesson in the books. Don't forget to take our practice quizzes and keep on working with the resources at NurseHub.